Good day, everyone. Today's topic in new market development is just a continuation of what we have discussed about innovation. There are four types of innovation. These are the sustaining innovation, the breakthrough innovation, disruptive innovation, and basic research. What is a sustaining innovation? The sustaining innovation improves existing products. It does not create new markets or value markets, but develops existing ones with better value, allowing companies to compete against each other sustaining improvements. Pagka sinabi natin sustaining innovation, walang bago, no? In-improve lang natin yung dati. Halimbawa, yung mga mobile phones natin, ano? Kunyari, meron kang iPhone. So, from time to time, nag-i-innovate ang company ng iPhone para mas maging user-friendly at mas maging comprehensive ang uses niya. The second type of innovation is the breakthrough innovation. The breakthrough innovation is defined as an innovation from inside a company that pushes something to the next level. It is innovation that opens the company to new markets or changes the way customers interact with the market or the industry. The Zipcar is a good example of the breakthrough innovation. Another example is the Apple iPhone. It is a breakthrough product. Sumikat yan sa market. Actually, yung mga nauna, tulad ng mga Nokia, naunahan na niya, no? Na naungusan na ng Apple iPhone. The third one is the disruptive innovation. This refers to a technology whose application significantly affects the way a market or industry functions. An example of modern disruptive innovation is the internet, which significantly altered the way companies did business and which negatively impacted companies that were unwilling to adapt to it. Because everybody is using the internet, so marami talagang binago ang pamumuhay, ano? Nitong tinatawag na internet industry. At marami ding kinita yan. Marami ding binigyan ng trabaho, mga bloggers, YouTubers, yan. At hindi lang maliit ang kinikita, milyon ang kinikita niyan. Ang tawag dyan ay disruptive innovation. The fourth type of innovation is the basic research. The results of basic research feed into applied research and development, which in turn lead to production and sales on the market. Research is regarded as the driver of innovation, while in most cases, the key driver is a need found among certain users in the market or within a company. Likewise, it underestimates the many reverse processes and feedback loops inherent in technological change. A commonly used example is the transistor, which was developed years before the underlying scientific principles were formulated. Innovations in applied research may thus constitute an important input into basic research. Those are the four types of innovation. As a summary, innovation is, at its core, about solving problems, and there are as many ways to innovate as there are different types of problems to solve. Just like we wouldn't rely on a single marketing tactic for the life of an organization or a single source of financing, we need to build up a portfolio of innovation strategies designed for specific tasks. Leaders identify the right type of strategy to solve the right type of problem just by asking two questions: how well we can define the problem, and how well we can define the skill domains needed to solve it. Well-defined problems that benefit from well-defined skills fall into the category of sustaining innovation. Being able to reach out to scientists on the cutting edge can help a business plan for the future, just as the other approaches, such as design thinking, open innovation, business model innovation, and others, can help propel a business forward if applied in the right context. But no one solution fits all problems. If your innovation strategy is struggling or failing, consider whether it's because you've locked yourself into a single approach. There are always new problems to solve. Learn to apply the solution that best fits your current problems. And that concludes our lesson in Chapter 2. And may you have a great day. Thank you.